My name is Melanie Macho. I'm with Doka Mormon New York Tri-State, an international organization that seeks to document and preserve and create a conversation around modernism and the modern movement.
My story in terms of preservation is very simple. I got into historic preservation about 5 years ago due to all of the development that was going on in the neighborhood of Mott Haven. It's great to participate. This is the 25th anniversary. Mott Haven was chosen as one of the six to celebrate. And when that happened, it brought tremendous attention to the cost of preservation in the South Bronx.
My name is Brad Vogel. There's a group of us, including HTC, that started a coalition to call for landmarking in the neighborhood of Gowanus in Brooklyn. HTC has been crucial to the process. They're meeting with city council members with us. They are helping put up a petition that people are signing electronically.
My critics and allies will tell you that I am the strongest advocate on the city council for preservation.
In New York City, a lot of our economy is based around real estate, building new real estate, and as a result, we see our past getting forgotten, and anyone who lives in these old buildings being pushed out of our city.
Preservationists know a lot. It can be intimidating, especially to insecure elected officials who are faking it till they make it and whose worst nightmare is being exposed. So start off by acknowledging that you've got the expertise.
Historic Districts Council has really provided as a convener. We've got a great conference like this where we can get all the folks in the room to just be very honest about how we can take on, in some cases, more money than God and win.
It's not just about the preservation, it's about an experience that's so unique that I feel like so many people are craving.
I originally wanted to be an architect, but kind of found my way towards the nonprofit sector. Now I raise money and work on communications for all kinds of different projects all throughout the city.
I grew up in the Midwest. This slide's slightly a joke. Yeah, Midwestern! This slide's slightly a joke. Actually, I grew up in Minneapolis. It does not look like this, but
it's shocking. It is absolutely shocking what happens when you don't have people fighting. The gravity of the world wants to destroy Grand Central, wants to destroy Penn State. That is where the money, the power, and it's in direct opposition to what every resident of a city wants. So you need people there fighting, and 50 years of people fighting is a good thing.
HTC has really impacted my life, and I know my fellow preservationists. They made us believe that this is possible. When everything seems so impossible, they really help us, you know, just get the strength and the courage to really make it happen.
People forget the beauty and how sturdy older things are, how beautiful the bare bones are. I mean, I own a home that's 118 years old. Stuff is beautiful, but when you look at something that was made, you know, a staircase, just mahogany, and the work that went into it, tin ceilings, they don't make those anymore the way they used to. Just the beauty of it, and to have an organization that helps you preserve that and navigate all this political stuff. Yeah, they need to be around for another 150 more years.